Hey guys, thank you for joining me this week in my new video. If you're new here, welcome. So for this week I have planned a recipe. Well, it's not edible, but it's awesome. It's kind of like an experiment. I saw online that you can make your own kinetic sand. So if you don't know what kinetic sand is, it's like sand you can play with, like Play-Doh. Only then made of sand, so you can just use it indoors, it's safe, and apparently you can make that yourself. So that's what I'm going to attempt this week. So I'll take you through the recipe, and if you want to, you can make it yourself. I have no clue if it will work, but yeah, let's try it out, right? So first of all, I'm going to show you what you need to make this. Well, obviously you need sand, and you can't just get like any old sand. It has to be the play sand, so obviously. What you also need is cornstarch. And the recipe says soapy water. Yeah, I have no clue what they mean with that, but I just used like tap water and like Dreft. Just mix that together and then you have everything. So the measurements are cup wise. So you have 3 cups of sand, 2 cups of cornstarch and 1 cup of soapy water. And then you mix that. So yeah, I'll just show you what I have and yeah, then we'll get to it, I guess. So here you have my sand. That's 3 cups worth of. My cornstarch, of course, my soapy water, some cups, because apparently you can also use food coloring to color the sand, so let's try it out. So I'm just going to mix everything up. I need 2 cups of cornstarch. So for those of you who never heard of kinetic sand, it's been around for a while now. It was like the hot thing a few years back. And the first time I saw it, I was like so amazed. Because it looked so satisfying to just knead that sand or whatever, you know. Oh wow, there's cornstarch everywhere. Nothing new. So that's the first cup. Going to need 2 cups of that. That's probably like the whole packet. Doesn't matter, I bought 4 just in case. You never know, maybe it won't work. So I'm going to see if it works, and if it does, I think I'm going to have like a happy son, because this is awesome to play with. I have no clue if you can like keep it or whatever, but I'm guessing if you put it in like airtight container, it will stay good for a while. So I'm just going to mix in the cornstarch with the sand. Looks so weird, grayish. I'll show you in a minute. I hope it will work. I think that's cool. And much more cheap than actually buying it, because that stuff ain't cheap. Okay. So, when you actually put it all together, it looks like this. So it's this like, yeah, I don't know, grayish, whitish substance. It feels really soft, like if you have a dream of like spending a vacation in, I don't know, Hawaii with the white beaches, I'm guessing that's what the sand's supposed to be. So let's see if it works. So next is the soapy water. I hope I'm doing this right. So that's 1 cup of soapy water going in. Ugh. Okay, let's see. Mix it in. Well, it smells nice. That's something, I guess. Ugh. It's turning into goo. Don't know if that's supposed to happen. Oh, and now it's turning rock hard. I don't know if that's supposed to happen. Ugh. Ugh. Oh boy. Yeah, it sort of looks like cement now. Ugh. And it's really hard to combine. Okay, you guys, I'm going in. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. It sort of feels like a stretchy dough kind of thing. Oh, that is awesome. Okay, you need to see this. Just wait a second. Look at this. It doesn't look one bit like kinetic sand yet, but I'm guessing I have to knead it some more. But, oh wow. That is awesome. But it looks nothing like kinetic sand. So I'm just going to mix it a bit, which is very satisfying. And then I'll get back to you. So I've been mixing it for about like 20 minutes. And I kept adding sand to it because it just stayed too runny. So I think I have it until the right consistency now. It's like, yeah, it's a steady consistency. But if you keep it in your hand, it gets a bit runny. But not runny as in it's dripping everywhere. So I'll show you how it looks. So this is what I meant. It's a steady consistency, but it's still a bit oozy. So if you put it in your hand and keep kneading it, it's like this dough. But then if you don't move it around anymore, it sort of like oozes. I think that's the right consistency. So I'm going to try to color it. I have three colors. Red, blue and green. And of course, me being a Christmas addict, I'm going to mix the blue and the green. The blue and the yellow here and the red here. So let's see how that works out. So this is like normal food coloring. You can just buy that in the supermarket. Usually you use that for like cookies or fondant or whatever. Let me just get the other ones. So that's yellow and some blue, which will hopefully make green. So that just looks like mustard. And that, I don't know, like a berry coulis. So let's mix it up, see how it gets. So I just put every last drop of red dye in there and it didn't really work out. So I think it's because there was just too much sand. So brilliant me went on with the green one, which actually turned out pretty good. However, of course, I didn't really think this through, like always. And now I'm stuck with these. Yeah. It's dye, so I'm guessing that's going to be on my hands for a while. So I look like a passive-aggressive Hulk on one hand side. Yeah, didn't really think it through. Anyway, I think it sort of worked out. Let me show you the results. So this is the red one. It's not even pinkish. It's just gray. So yeah. But we have green sand. Woohoo! So that's pretty cool. And it actually is working pretty okay as well. If it will just come out a bit, I'll show you. Because kinetic sand, you're supposed to make that in a shape. And then, okay, this looks worse than it is. It's just stuck to the bowl a bit. Okay. So, you have this shape here. It actually feels pretty good. It's really, it's a really calming thing to do. Just need to sand a bit. Okay, moving on. So, you have this shape. I don't know what shape I'm going to make, but let's just make it like a blob. Okay, you have a shape, look. And then you can actually cut it. It doesn't really stay into shape, so I'm guessing there's too much of something in there. But, well, it doesn't totally liquefy, so you can actually knead it, which is pretty cool. It's like a sandy Play-Doh. Wow, my hands look green. It doesn't look that green in real life. I'm not even using a filter, but this just looks ridiculous. Looks like somebody at the police station went all out with the green ink. So yeah. It's actually pretty satisfying to play with this. I mean, you can knead it, you can make all sorts of shapes, and you can cut it and use like the cookie cutters to make shapes in it. And yeah, well, it's like Play-Doh, only then sandy. Don't really think this is suitable for little children. I have no clue if this die actually keeps on giving, if you know what I mean. So I'm going to have to check that out once I clean my hands myself. So, for a chance for a shout out in my new video, who can tell me which figure this is? Wait. Okay, it's a bit runny. Should be more like this, but if you know which figure this is, let me know. Yeah, now I look at it, it's not going to be easy, but hey. Shout out for the first one who names it right. I spent the last half hour scrubbing my hands with a sponge with the scratchy thingy on it. Yeah, there's no way in hell I'm going to let my son play with that green one, because it's less, but it's still green. I still have to go to work tomorrow. We have a company event. Maybe I can play the mascot. Still wrong color though. Oh well. That's it for this week's video. I have some cleaning to do, because I have bowls full of colored sand, and there is sand and cornstarch everywhere. So yay! I hope you like this video. It's a little bit short, but hey, trying something new here. If you liked it, please let me know. Shout out on the comments if you know what the answer to my riddle is. Also, if you like it, please consider subscribing to my vlogs. You can do that by clicking on subscribe. Also, click the bell button so you get notifications every time I post a new video. That will be every Thursday. Next to that, you can find me on Facebook and also on Instagram. So come and find me there. As of now, it's only 195 days left till Christmas. We're in the 100s, so get a move on. Until then, spread some joy. And for the love of Christmas, be yourself. Everybody else is already taken. See you guys next week. Bye.